Welcome back. Did you know Johnson C. Smith University here in Charlotte had a baseball team? I didn't know that. They did, and they had some really good players that would put up some numbers comparable to the heavy hitters that we see in the MLB today. Our Larry Sprinkle takes us to their campus near Uptown to learn more about their team and the other Negro League players.
This week, Johnson C. Smith University opened up their exhibit about the Negro League's baseball. It's all about the many accomplishments of African Americans in the sports, including legends like Satchel Paige.
The hope is to show the school and the entire Charlotte community the history of Charlotte Black baseball.
We have local stories, and we want to hear them. And understanding that those family stories, they're a part of this. They're a part of baseball history.
Back in the days when African American players were not allowed on Major League Baseball teams, the Negro Leagues fielded all black teams of professional players. The display is in the campus's James B. Duke Memorial Library, open to anyone who wants to learn and understand more about baseball history.
We hear big name players, Jackie Robinson, of course, for breaking the color barrier, but there's so many other players and so many other accomplishments that we don't talk about.
There's a lot of photos of famous Negro League players, players that made it to the National League or the Major Leagues from the Negro League.
Here you can see the pictures and the artifacts that truly take you back to another place in time. The exhibit was made possible by a generous loan from the Negro League Baseball Museum in Kansas City, combined with other pieces from the JCSU baseball team and the Charlotte Negro League team. This special one-of-a-kind exhibit shows the major importance of the Negro League to the history of baseball in the United States.
This is a lost history, and I think when it comes to an HBCU, having this kind of exhibit shows that these players led the way in so many ways.
So I'm hoping this kind of sparks a love of history. Some of the kids, some of them have walked around and been like, yeah, I didn't know there were black players before Jackie Robinson. So hopefully it unlocks a bit of history that these kids don't know about yet, and some of these adults don't know about maybe.
Because segregation had taken hold in the late 1800s, especially in the South, most of the successful Negro League teams were up north.
Kansas City, Chicago, Pennsylvania, New York. But there were some local teams, the Charlotte Quicksteps, the Charlotte Black Hornets, Charlotte Red Sox.
We need to look at what these players did across the board for social justice, as well as in baseball history.
On the campus of Johnson C. Smith University, I'm Larry Sprinkle. Back to you.
There's so many cool facts and things to learn about what happened back then. So if you want to catch the exhibit, check for the link to our web story on WCNC.com. You have until June 7th to get that history lesson. It's one you won't want to miss. The library is open on weekdays, but closed on weekends.